Oh, welcome back to Imperial Splendor, Empire Total War. I've taken this place that I said I would do. He had loads and loads of troops hidden and it was taking forever, so I did actually go in and have a bit of a fight with him, so I did lose some men, but not very many at all. So I'm repairing the barracks. I want to bring my dragoons in as well, really. Oh, maybe they need to go in there, do they? Yeah, they do. Ah, it's this place that's not happy, isn't it? Minus two. What if I've got a couple of dragoons in here I can put in? I think I have. These two, perhaps? Speed that up a little bit. Right. Yellow. Brilliant. Okay, that's good. Oh, I thought I was going to have to, you know, untax one or something, but that's great news, isn't it? It was just a little too easy, though, wasn't it? I'm not convinced about that. Anyway, what else did I want to do? Yeah, I think... over in the Americas. Right, let's get over to there. I was thinking about that fifth rate, actually. I was thinking about moving that. But let's do the Americas first. That's why I was a bit sort of reticent there, wasn't it? Now, I think this is Montanez over here. This is the place, isn't it? That's it. Montanez. I don't know what that says. I don't know. I could find out. It's... it just says Montanay, doesn't it? Montanay. Oh, that's not... Montanay? Montana? Nothing to do with that, is it, really? Well, I don't know, is it? But anyway, Montanay it says on there. Right, I'm going to take out my entire army from here. I'm not really sure that if I need the entire army or not, but I'm going to get them all out. And it looks like that's the shortest route to get them onto there, so let's take that route then. I'm really surprised that it didn't move the ship towards us, actually. And I think it was BFAS who pointed this one out. He's quite right. I mean, this is an easy target for me, isn't it, really, this Newfoundland. So I need to go in there and take this. It's only rebels that have got it, so it should be very, very easy for me to take that. So, okay. I know the guns won't be able to move, but... the rest of the force might just be able to. What's he got in there? He's got... Oh, damn, he's got these... Well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to auto-resolve that. Because it's just a nuisance. It's a pain fighting them, isn't it? We're already replenishing these troops anyway, aren't we? Oh, actually, we can move part of the way, even with the guns. That surprises me. Okay, I'll probably get away with, say, less than 100 losses against this lot, you know? 482... 547. I've got more than him. I know I can fight and beat them. They're only small units as well, but anyway. Okay, I'm going to auto-resolve it anyway, so surrender refused. And oh, look. Was that 33? That's a gift, isn't it? It really is. It just makes so much more sense, doesn't it, really? I'm going to get my trading port in here. This is the advantage of getting it. This is what BFAS was talking about, really. You know, sort of, have you considered it and why not? Or whatever, I can't remember how it was phrased. But it really is a good place to just, you know, send, you know, trade across there, isn't it? But, okay, so I'm going to build that up. And this, I can't build anything from that, so I have to get rid of that one, I'm afraid. So I'm not sure what I need to do with this. Probably untax it, do I? It's completely red. I think that is going to have to be untaxed. Yes, it is. I'm going to have to remember that that's been untaxed. That's something I'm likely to forget. Actually, I think it might be alright for one turn, if I think about it. Because they were alright last turn, weren't they? I know I didn't get much for them, but it's there, isn't it? Yeah, no, I'm going to keep that, you know. Just for this turn. Because the previous turn, I'm sure they were green. I'm sure they were absolutely fine. I'm going to keep it. Okay. Now, one place I am going to have to exempt from tax. And I don't know if you remember on my previous video, I said I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this. You see this area here? You know, this is the one that that they're not happy in. I did say I might bring my troops back to it, but I've decided against. Oh, it's just the middle classes that are unhappy. So. Right, good. So I'm going to move these. I think these are being replenished as well. Yes, they are. Are they all being replenished? Yeah, they are. Okay, and I'm going to take those over to here. But before I commit myself to any kind of an attack, what I want to do really is get my agent up there to go and have a look at them. And see what they've got, actually. I think the army's going to get there well before the agent. Oh yeah, look at that. The army will be there in one or two turns. He's going to take about four. I'm not sure there's any point in that, really. I don't know. We might be able to kill a chieftain or something when the time comes. I expect I'm going to need to be building up these forces in here anyway. So, and I can't recruit anybody in here yet, of course, because I haven't even built this. So, right, okay, I don't want to be spending any more money over there either yet. So, what else did I want to do? That fifth rate. Do you remember I said something about the fifth rate and what I was going to do about it? Well, I'm just going to bring him back to Portsmouth for now. If you remember, I took the agent over to Denmark because I want to see what happens to the place if I leave somebody in there, because Denmark has unrealistically stayed alive for a long time. Although Dutch delights, you know, amazed me, that bit of information that he gave to me. Very, very interesting. Right, well, you see there, 62 every turn. He's losing, his economy's dwindling each turn, worse than Britain's is at the moment, I think. And, well, not sure, I see, when I think about it. Yeah, it is. It's 3% from 68. It's pretty, actually, 3% from 175. Yeah, I don't know, really. Might be on a par with ours, but... Okay, I say ours, I mean ours in real life, you know. Now, I think... I know what else I need to do. Oh, blimey, I need to get a drink of tea, don't I? Whew, that's better. Voice is going. In fact, it's still going. Right, I think what I'm going to do is drink a little more tea off camera. What I want to do is move these troops into more reasonable places. At the moment I've got two places, two islands when I took them that have too many troops on them. So, if you just give me a tick, I'm going to have a bit of a cough and drink a bit more tea. So, I won't be coughing in your faces. Hang on a second. Okay, I think I'm a little bit more normal now. Oh, crikey, voice went again then. Right, okay, what I want to do is get some of these chaps. I've not planned on any number or something, but I know they're going to be very happy. Look at that. So, what I could really do with is getting some in these other places, perhaps somewhere to protect someone to protect that port, for instance, and, you know, and when I start to build up some trade over there. So, let's take four over here. Okay, and then if I get, what, three of them on the ship, maybe? Yep. Okay, that way, obviously, I can leave one behind. And, you know, to protect that port while he's gone. Mind you, actually, that's a shipyard. That's where, really, I should be raising my my new ships, isn't it, really? My new warships. I'd forgotten about that, you know. Forgotten it was there. Right, why can't we move further? Oh, we can. That's just our zone of control, isn't it? Okay, over to here, I think. And distribute these chaps. I'm not sure I need all of them, actually. Is it just two? I'm just going to have a look at that, actually. There's already a unit in there, isn't there? Yeah, I just need one, really, just to cover that port. So, let's get one out of there. Okay, good. And then move on with the fleet to somewhere else. Where? Here, perhaps? He's got two in there. I need to distribute those a bit more sensibly as well, don't I, really? He hasn't got anything in here. So I'll bring him down to here, then. Okay, and then perhaps just leave the remaining two in here. Yep. Okay, I probably need one to go down to Dutch Guiana as well, don't I? I think this is French Guiana, isn't it? No, this is Dutch Guiana, sorry. French Guiana. I'll need one for French Guiana as well, I think. But for now, let's just cover that port there, because they're all trading ports, you see. They're all going to be important to me to look after. And I've got the men there anyway. It's just a shame to waste them, isn't it, otherwise? So, right, I'm going to leave him there for now, because I don't want to you know, have him sort of swanning around on his own, tempting somebody to go to war with me, because, well, because he can. Actually, no, let's put him in there. If I'm going to pick up anybody to move somewhere else, it's going to be one with a chevron, isn't it? Right, okay, well, that sort of fills the ports a bit, but there's another island with some on as well. Is it this one? I think it must be. Yeah, what have I got in here? Right, four in there. Right, well, if I leave one in the port and bring out the others, so, same thing again. So, no, actually, let's take the better ones Okay, because I think they're going to be more needed. And then put the two good ones onto the ships. On there. Good. And then, what navy have I got? Oh, this is the good navy, isn't it? This is my main military fleet, really. If I take them over to, I don't know, here where that sloop is somewhere. This one. Okay. And maybe the sloop will be able to... won't be able to get there and back, will it? But, well, it can get nearly back. Oh Lord, it's got a lot of movement. There's a chance, isn't there? Let's give it a go. Okay. All those, but not that one. Okay, and then. Oh, look at that! Look how close that is, eh? Right. Okay. Right now, him. I want to come back to here eventually, because that's going to be my sort of central area, isn't it? So, okay. So it's all about dropping those troops off there. I wonder, actually, if I select the troops and ask them to go to there, will it do it? It will. Look at that. Right, okay. Let's do that then. So, during the turn end, or whenever, next turn or something like that, it'll actually do the whole movement and put the troops in there for me. So, yeah, that's good, isn't it? I think that's about it. If you remember, we were ganging up on Venice down here. Whoops. It's really because I wanted to make provision for him attacking me, which is what I expect him to do. And I didn't want to be caught napping. I don't think he's going to declare war on me now, because I think I've cut the pass off now for him, so I can't see him coming through there. It's tempting just to go in and attack him, isn't it, really? But I can't reach yet, because we've only just got down there anyway. I don't really want to recruit more up there yet, so I think I can just hang on to the money. I don't think I need... I don't think I need to worry about money anywhere else, do I? Let's have a quick look through the regions and just check if everybody's happy. They might not all be being taxed, but they should be happy. Oh, that's the one that's just the middle classes, isn't it? So I'm going to leave them. Everyone else being taxed... On a brief inspection, it looks like... Oh, hang on. Oh no, that's the one I've just untaxed, isn't it? So, apart from that, I think everywhere is taxing. And I've got... Whoops. I've got a fairly decent amount of money coming in, haven't I? Hey, that's a point. What about that other ship? That fleet that was going to go back to join the... Join those on the trade hub. Ah, right, okay. He's still on his way, isn't he? So I'll leave him to it. Anyway, okay, let's go for it then, see what happens. It really was a long, long battle. A few hours of mortar attacking the enemy who were hidden behind... This is Hungary, by the way. Who were, you know, sort of behind hills and all sorts of things. But what they did was some of his troops routed just outside... Oh, hang on. Oh, right, okay. That's where the Swedish army was going. It was going towards Denmark. I don't know if you remember, was it the last video or the one before that, where I said, oh no, the Swedes have got troops afloat. And of course they were on their way, weren't they, to Iceland. What was that then? In fact, will they be able to land an army that's big enough to take on the Danes? Because, I mean, the Danes are, you know, pretty strong there. What's this? Intercept. That's pretty much in my favour, isn't it? But I've got guns here. It's just these things that so annoy me, isn't it? So, are they all? 250, 450, 443, 554. You know, with an army like this, they're all missile troops, aren't they? You know what I'm going to do with this? Tell you what, I'm just going to charge him with my horse. Why not? Just let the horse run rampant amongst him. We're just going to completely destroy him, aren't we, with the horse that we've got. In fact, I tell you what have I got there? 50, 100, 107. He's only got 180 in total. I've got almost as many horse as he's got men. And so we could completely destroy the army. Oh, wow. Okay, well, I'm going to go for this then. Bit of grape shot, bit of ball, and then charge in while he's... As soon as he fires at my guns, charge in the horse and finish him off. So... I think we should be able to get the whole lot of them, shouldn't we? I don't know. Anyway, let's give it a try. Well, here we are. I have to decide where I'm going to form up. It's tempting, isn't it, to get behind a defensive position, actually, and just line up around here, because he wouldn't even be able to get at me over there. The only thing is, he doesn't need to get at me anyway, because these troops are not hand-to-hand troops that he's got, are they? What he wants to do, of course, is to just come shooting at me from a long distance. I think I'll form up here, then. Along here. Say... I don't know, here, okay, and then put my long firing troops, say there, and then my other gun, here. Such a shame that he outranges even my canister shot, isn't it really, but okay, live with it, hey? Right, is that a good idea? No, just back just a little. Bearing in mind, he's not likely to actually engage in hand-to-hand in this one, is he? So, okay, so we're not likely to shoot across our own men this time, are we? Okay, well, let's hope not anyway. So, this one and this one. Fairly depleted units, of course, but having said that, it doesn't matter too much, does it? Because they are being replenished. Slowly, but surely. They're only militia, as has been pointed out to me quite correctly. I've been thinking that they're not. I've been thinking that they are actual decent quality line infantry. And that, they certainly aren't. Oh dear, right, okay, I can't even get in there. Maybe I should give another one of them away to this side then. yeah, okay. Okay, and then just fit these two into here. Right, flank's covered anyway. Good. Now, horse. These are the main boys, aren't they? So I'm going to have him over here. Are they my horse as well? No, they're the infantry. Okay, good. Horse a little bit further back. I don't want them to be engaged by his archers, do I? I just want to release my horse after him when I'm ready. Okay, well, these horse up here. Presumably they'll be hidden. They damn well should be, anyway. Probably means he'll be able to see them and start firing at them straight away, but... Oh, stop grumbling. There we go again. Now, these here, or rather the general, I know he's going to want to shoot at the general, so I'll keep the general as far back as I possibly can. I think that's about it, isn't it? Well, let's just go for it then and see what he does. Right. We should be shooting at him. Right. Okay, now as soon as he starts firing those bows, or you don't fire bows, why do I say that all the time? As soon as he starts shooting those bows, then we're going in after him. As soon as one can shoot, you see, they can all shoot. See, I'm pretty sure he outranges my canister shot as well, you know. Ah! Of course, we can't even hit him from there, can we? Because we've got that hill in the way. I wasn't too bothered about that, to be honest with you, you know, because I don't expect to be hitting him with ball anyway. I could have gone to a much further back defensive position if I'd have wanted to do that. That's not my intention. My intention really is only to hit him with case shot when the occasion arises. Oh, looks like we've got one hit, though. Look at that. That seemed to do some damage. 30, 30, or maybe it didn't. 30, 30, no. No damage at all. Now, is he going to be able to fire from there? He is. Right, okay. And is he standing there? I think he is. Right, okay. So, let's just go get him then. Otherwise, he's just going to stand there, shooting over that hill at me. I'm not going to be able to do a darn thing about it, am I? So, let's go in and get him then, folks. That horse there. And this horse here. Yeah, he's shooting at my guns, you know. He is, you know. Look at that. Okay. Oh, we did kill somebody, though. Oh, that's not so bad then, is it? Alright, okay. Guns are going to stop firing any minute now. Gun and gun. Ready? Okay. Ceasefire guns. Right, now we're going to see some engine killing. I'm going to send the general in. He's going to go in later than the rest of them, of course. But I don't care. Right, I'm sending them not in the triangular formation that we get, the wedge formation, whatever you want to call it. I'm sending them in directly like this, for very obvious reasons. Okay. Now, let's take him out as well. And then this guy here needs to go for, I don't know, those aren't gone yet. Oh no, him, sorry. Him, he's the one I want. He could just chase somebody, the general. How are we doing? 48, actually. We did lose some men for 52. 44 from 55. So we did lose some, but hey, we should be getting some real chevrons here, shouldn't we? What's that? Enemy general killed. Oh, good. So he's going to tell me mine had then. Where? Why isn't he... Oh, he's gone. Right, okay, well, I'm just going to end battle on that one, because really, it should kill everybody he's got there, shouldn't it? And it'll probably sort of distribute some of the casualties as well amongst the rest of my army, so... I know I've taken hits there on the horse, but I think the alternative is not good. The infantry would have taken too long to get there, and they would have been shot to pieces on their way in. The artillery couldn't return fire properly, really, against all of those archers, because they could shoot above. I could have got a much more defensive position, of course, but I wanted to be far more aggressive on this occasion. I really wanted to get my horse in there amongst them, so partly to see how effective they were, and I can't wait to see the battle statistics, just to see how many Indians my horse actually killed. And I'd like to see that he didn't get any away, but it looks like he has. He's got 29 away. That's not fair, is it? I lost 20-something. Let's have a look. Okay. Horse, where are we? 11. And killed 51. And lost... what's the other one? 11, and is it 9? I don't know. Which one's the horse? Gendarmerie, right? 41 and lost 4. That's pretty good. Gained a chevron. That's the main thing I wanted. And these as well here, gained a chevron. So the men that they've lost will really be made up for by the fact that they've got improved fighting ability in the future. I think that's a good trade-off. And they're being replenished anyway. And more? Wow, this is a big one. Look at them all. Sort of flaming archers again, isn't it? Right. God, loads of them. Opportunity to intercept. Do I intercept or do I let him go? I suspect he's going to be on his way to attack the town that I've just left. Is he going to be able to reach in one move? I'm going to try it and see what happens. If I decline attack, where does he go? Nowhere. That's interesting, isn't it? That's very interesting. I thought he'd go on and try and attack the town. Anyway, okay, letters of demand. Letters of demand, no surprise. Workers on strike, wanted A. Does that mean they've damaged somewhere? It doesn't look like it, does it? No, it didn't say workers riot, did it? It said oh, right, it's this place. Well, it's only the middle classes, isn't it? So, I mean, to be honest, really, for 95... I think I'm going to let it go. I'm just going to exempt it. Whoops. Exempt it for this turn. Right, okay. I need to look at my regions and find out which ones are the most unhappy, don't I? Workers on strike, Montenay. Right, okay, we know about that one. Right, technology theft failed, right, because I want to sort out technology as well, don't I? So, I believe we've got another tech available to us, didn't we, last time? This one. See if there's anything else. Ah, ha, ha! Look at that. Naval architectural advances. Now, that would be a good one for me, because I think I'm researching that one anyway. And I'm 10 turns away from getting that. I'm going to put him on something else. In fact, I'm going to put him on here. Right, okay, we'll get him on there and see if I can get the naval architectural advances by stealing it. And then... I can't remember. Oh, it's this one, isn't it, that they're getting now, which is the carbines. I really don't want that. I see absolutely no point whatsoever. Maybe I can get another one of these. Lime juice and sauerkraut. Upkeep costs is good. Copper bottoms, I do like that one. Yeah, but the recruitment cost goes up, doesn't it? I wonder if maybe I should get something that's going to give me more money. Might be an idea. What about this puddling furnace? Recruitment cost for artillery, that sounds good. 20% generated by metalworking buildings, that also sounds good. I think I'll go for that one for now then. It's only 7 away as well, isn't it? That's good. Right, okay, well, let's go for that, see what we get. I'm part thinking that I might need it, you know, for these bayonet, or steel ramrods, or whatever they call them. Right, okay, yeah, okay, I don't think I need to do any more with those. They're the sort of Indian, well, two of them are the Indian places. New town emerges, Montenay. Oh, right. Huh, crikey, I've only been there 5 minutes, what it seems like anyway. I've built that up, haven't I? Right, I know. The one that I've just taken, I need to get, where is it? Okay, I need to get something in there, don't I? Like that, for instance. These, oh, I don't know how many troops I need in there. Ah, plus 7, wow. I wonder if I can get those round to Rupert's land. I might think about that, actually. I don't think I need them there, but... Anyway, he can be on his way to here, I think, wasn't it? Yep. Okay. And there are other sort of regions I need to sort of think about. New town emerges. Where's that one? Huron territory. Over here as well. Right. We're on yellow in there. They go red, don't they? How much do I get for it? 270. That's quite lucrative, you know, actually. I might risk this minus factor up here, actually, this middle class being unhappy. What can I do in it? Maybe I need to up the ante a little bit in here, get a little bit more repression. Do you know, if I can reach there now, he's really stumped, because I would wipe him out. Oh, look, that's all he's got. Can I attack there without him being able to come to the assistance? Right, let's see if I can. I can get there. But can he assist? No. Oh, we've got him. We've darn well got him, haven't we? And he hasn't got much to fire back with this. He's got one archer there. Literally one archer, not one archer unit. And 15 archers there. He's got 16 archers on the whole field. My artillery should be able to deal with them. These here, they're pretty good. 5, 4, 8. But I don't think they're as good as mine. They're not, you know, with the 11, 15 and 7. I know he gets a charge bonus. But he's also got to take a shot from me as he comes in, hasn't he? So I think we're going to murder him there. And in fact, to be quite honest with you, that is so much in my favour and so obvious a victory for myself that I'm just going to auto-resolve that one. Because I reckon we're going to get less than 100 casualties. 36. Yep. Okay, that's mine. Brilliant. Oh, wow. That is super. That means all his men have gone. What was he trying to do? Trying to lull me into an attack against a greater force? Or was he just on his way down to... I think he was on his way down to there. I do. That's worked out really well for me. Okay, get rid of that then. And see what other buildings there are in here I need to sort out. This one I think I can build on. Yes, I can. So I don't need to worry about that one. This one, fur trader, I can build on that as well. This one, communal farming, I can do nothing with that, I don't think. I'll have a look at that one in a minute. And port? A port! I have a port. Right, I must build the port. Town... A meeting hall, that's definitely going. I think I've already destroyed that, haven't I? Is that that? I'm not sure, actually. Okay, let's go and have a look around at these places. That one there can be upgraded. That one can't. I can't do anything with that. Lower classes, middle classes, technology research rate, points per turn, spawns rakes. I'm just going to get rid of that one. Definitely want the port. There it is. Right, trading port. Now, were they trading any... They were. Well, I can, rather. Fur pelts. That's going to be good for me. That's going to be really good for trade. It'll also open up this trade route around here, which means that I'll be able to see what's going on around there. That's excellent. Right, okay. I should perhaps upgrade that fur trader, but I'm not going to for now. Is there anything else around here? Maybe the meeting hall is the one that's going to have to become the church. Something's going to have to happen anyway. And this... See, that's another one I'm going to have to destroy because I can't upgrade it. So that's going to have to go as well. Okay, not a lot of money there. 5,600. And of course the Venetians didn't attack me. That's really, really surprising. Okay, region captured, Rupert's Land. Hey, do you know, we've got rid of all the northern Indians. Nation destroyed, Cree. Yep, thank you very much. Good. Trait gained, thank you. Actually, you know, the comments have been specially useful in this campaign, more so than normal. I've been quite reticent in this campaign because France has sort of separated out and all over the place, and I felt very, very insecure about this campaign and about what I can do, which is unusual for me, really. No, I'm going to take both of those off. It is quite unusual for me, but I think partly because I can't get decent troops in these, you know, decent horse troops in these areas. That's what sort of put me off, really. And then when I got some horse, not many of them, but I got some, I was sort of careful with them, wasn't I? But I've wiped out all the Indians now, I think, up there, in those northern parts, anyway. I now need, really, to start reinforcing these other areas down here, so the Cherokee become friendly again. If it's possible, they might do. I'm not sure, actually. He's got three in there now. He might be threatening. He could well take that place there. I need to pay attention to that. I also need to build up Quebec now a bit and see if I can get some more troops in there. It's more expense, of course, but that's the way it's going to have to go. And again, I'm in the position of thinking, yeah, now I can start building up my economy. Isn't life good? But I think for now I'm going to have to perhaps get some troops around the Americas. I've left some places pretty exposed. Some of them I feel okay about. The one next to the Cherokee, perhaps not. And Quebec, so close to the Americans. You know how keen the Americans are on Quebec, you know, well, have been in the past. So I need to be careful about that as well. So, but the Venetians did not declare war. Strangely enough, they did not declare war. Right, okay, well, it's back to the drawing board. I need to think about what I'm going to do next. I think what I'm going to be doing, though, of course, is spending some money on those buildings that I destroyed last time in the Indian Territories, and also perhaps maybe declaring war on the Venetians. If they're not going to be aggressive towards me, perhaps I should be aggressive towards them. Let's go and have a look at what's happening over here, though, with these guys. We know the ships have landed. Oh, it'll even show me the ships. Brig, 6 or 8... Oh, they're not... What's that? Second-rate ship of the line. Wow. Hey, I tell you what, it's going to be worth taking Sweden, you know, if they've got facilities like that, if they've got shipworks like that. Now, this is puzzling me, because there are only 4 units in there, so that means the rest of the army... Oh, look at what he's got as well. The rest of the army must have gone towards the port to attack the Swedes. Let's go and have a look, see what's going on. Oh, yes. Right, ah-ha-ha. So we see a large Danish army, which, oh, it's got, it's had hits, actually. I don't know how full that army is, actually. And then these here, I'm not sure if that one's tattered or not. I can't quite make it out. But he's only got 11. I think he's got some posh-looking troops, anyway. What's that, 150? They are, oh, they're elite foot guards. Right, so he's got some decent troops. Got elite foot guards and line infantry. Some dragoons to help settle the place. Only 11 in total, though. This is a full 20. Whether all the units are full or not is a different matter. These, though, are simply militia. Lots and lots of guns. I don't think that army can beat an elite guard and regular infantry army. I really don't. Only if it stands and gets pummeled by the guns will it fail. So it just has to go. I mean, the number of actual troops it's fighting against. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then count the general is 10. Call it 9, really. No general. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I think that's their victory, that one. But anyway, I'm going to watch that. That's a nice little fight, isn't it? He's obviously struggling to recruit any decent troops in here. I think that's what his problem's going to be. Yeah, look at this. Oh, he can get... What's that? Looks like Lotto Dragoons. Lotto Dragoner. Lotto. So you have to be lucky with that one, I think. One chance in a million that they're going to win. and even that's a heck of a lot better than the lottery we play over here. Right, I think... Settled. Well, we know they're settled anyway. We can see they're green, can't we? Okay, thinking time, folks. Why didn't the Venetians attack me? I'm sure they would have intended to. Let me just show you why I think it, by the way. If I go over to Venice here, you'll see I'm on a -4. Now, that's while things are still going good for us. They won't trade with me, by the way. I've tried between videos. I always try to do the trading thing, so I don't spend too long fiddling about on videos themselves. But, you know, look at that. Okay, we've got the same religion going for us, and that's about it. You know, national leaders command respect. Other than that, we've had it. I don't know what the espionage is. I don't think I've indulged in any with him. It's just the different government type, isn't it, really? There is nothing going well for us, you know, with the Venetians. So I'm sure they want to attack me. I can only think we've just become too powerful for them now in that area, which is not a bad thing. And although I've left my areas behind here, and that's, okay, fairly decently lucrative, 960 whatever, I can't see either of these going for, oh, it's a 183. You might decide, actually. Might decide to swap. And this one, 12-something. I think these have got a lot vested in not attacking me here, because if he does, I'm going to double back, aren't I, at least with this army, and take this place and this place. Yeah, there's no doubt about it. And then gang up on here as well, and then build up some more troops to hold the Venetians. I honestly don't think it's wise for either of these to go for it or anything. I'm sure that must be worked out mathematically by the AI in this. So anyway, moving on. Oh, I know, one other thing. Oh, I think about this all the time, one thing after another. That there, I am going to need my magnifying glass on that again. It's just sort of faded between the black and the grey on here. What's that? That is 30. Is it 31 or 34? I think that's 31. 31 out of 50, and we're not halfway through the campaign yet, and these are the struggling years, of course. If we carry on at that pace, we'll have 62 before the end of the before the end of the game. But obviously it gets quicker as you go along, like it has just done now a few territories in this video. So okay, thanks again, and finally, for watching.